Hey there, it's Seb Frey here with yet another exciting episode of Seb Frey TV. Gee, that last episode sure was exciting, the one where I talked about cultural appropriation. Got a little fraught there in some of the social media. And so today I'm going to go back to my knitting, back to my bailiwick, which is talking about real estate. And there's one thing I really want to talk about today, which is how important it is to get your home under contract within the first 2 or 3 weeks that it's on the market. Now, why is that important? Well, here's why. Because let's just say that you have a house. It's a 3-bedroom, 2-bathroom house, and it's located in like Willow Glen in San Jose, and you're asking $1.5 million for it, right? Now, let me ask you this. How many people right now do you think are looking for a 3-bedroom, 2-bathroom house in Willow Glen in about the $1.5 million price range? Do you have any idea? I don't, but let's just say it's 100 people, okay? So there's 100 people who are looking for a house just like yours in the neighborhood that your house is in, sort of in the ballpark price range that your house is listed for, okay? So during the first 2 or 3 weeks that your property's on the market, all 100 of those buyers, if they are real active buyers, all 100 of them, or however many are interested seriously in your property, they will see it within that first 2 or 3 weeks. And then what's going to happen? Well, either they're going to make an offer on the property the first 2 or 3 weeks, or they're not going to make an offer on the property. And then what's going to happen is that all of the active buyers at that moment in time for your property, they'll all go through. And if they don't make an offer on your property, if none of those 100 people or whatever it is doesn't make an offer on your property in that time, what's going to happen is your property is going to sit on the market and it's going to get stale. You will still get some showings, but you will get a lot less showings, right? You'll get people at the open houses, but you'll get a lot more looky-loos at the open houses. You won't get the actual hardcore committed buyers who want to buy a property right now. And so your property is probably going to sit on the market. And there's been many, many studies that show the longer your home sits on the market, the less it sells for. And it sells for less in relation to asking price and relation to actual market value, whatever that might be, right? So there's many studies that show that your home, the longer it takes to sell, the less it will actually sell for, which is why it is critical to get the price for your property set absolutely correctly so that in those first 2 or 3 weeks, you will have buyers who make an offer. Ideally, you would have more than one buyer. Ideally, you would have like 2, 3, 4 buyers, a little bit of competition, so you can suss out who of all the buyers in the for the property right now, who is actually the most motivated, the one who really likes your property the best. You know, the last 3 listings I put out this spring, all 3 of them got multiple offers, and it was wonderful in each of those cases to have, first of all, overbids, and then to actually, you know, be in the driver's seat and not have to, like, you know, have the one buyer with the one contract who came in and, first of all, lowballed and nickel and dimed for every single last little defect, real or imagined, in the property. It's so much a superior experience to have multiple offers in the wings, because then the buyers, you know, they reinforce among each other that, hey, this is a very desirable property. Hey, I really shouldn't rake the seller over the coals over these minor defects, because I know that if I do, the seller is just gonna bam, kick me out of contract and move on to the next buyer. So it's really important that you have your property set correctly, where the pricing will attract offers within those first 2 or 3 weeks, because it will make all the difference in the price that you get for your property and the satisfaction and pleasure you have in selling your property. Because believe me, having your property on the market for months at a time is not a very fun way to sell your home. You can take it from me on that. All right, that is it for this episode of Seb Frey TV. Hey, do me a favor. Would you share this with all your friends and family and colleagues and coworkers or anybody you know who is thinking about buying or selling real estate? I would really appreciate it. All right, that wraps it up for this episode of Seb Frey TV. Stay tuned. I will have another episode up before too long.